Thank you. tonight is so much bigger than we even realize. Some of us may be sitting here. Maybe you feel him, maybe you don't. Honestly, it doesn't matter. Because what he's doing is so much bigger and so much greater than we can't even comprehend it. It's changing everything. Everything is changing right now. Circumstances, cultures, habits are breaking, dissipating, leaving as we worship. As we give highest praise, as we declare he reigns. When we put him way up high above all circumstances. High above everything. Lord, do heart surgery. Rewire us, God, to be more mindful. To think like you think. As we continue to worship, I want you to realize, as you worship, your circumstances are changing. A lot of us know that, but we need to hear it again. As we worship, circumstances change. Problems dissipate and disappear.
Anoint us for the greater things. Crying on Lisa, you are right. Verse I love in 1 Peter, and there was one line I remember when I was first saved. 2001, I was reading it one day, and it kind of startled me, because we know that angels live in the manifest glory of God, and they are in the throne room, and they cry, "Holy, holy, holy," continually. And it says in 1 Peter 1:12, it says, "It was revealed to them that they were not serving themselves, but you," which is us, "in these things which now have been announced to you," and it's talking about the message of salvation and things to come, "to you through those who preach the gospel to you by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven." And then it goes dot, dot, dot. Things into which angels long to look. So there was something that was brewing in heaven that even made the angels wonder, and it was the things to come, which was Jesus coming, I believe, you know. And the Father's love, I believe. And to me, I love just seeing pictures in my mind when I read the Word. And I just see like this, they get this glimpse of something and they just go off and they're chattering and talking. And they're like, "What do you think this is? What do you think this is? What do you think this is?" It's like gospel of heaven, only it's righteous, you know, because it's heaven. So, and it's true, you know. And, you know, Gabriel's like, because he probably knows, because he's the one that gets to talk to Mary. I don't know if, you know, God gave him a heads up or not and said, hey, there's coming a day. But it's things that angels long to look into, and it's like, what would angels long to look into? You know, they've been with God since the beginning when he created them. They were around when he created heaven and earth. They were around, you know, when the armies fought and they saw, you know, Lucifer cast down. They saw all these things, but there was the one thing that they longed to look into. And I was reading it many years back, and I just felt like the Holy Spirit said it was the Father's heart for people that he created. And why? Why on earth do you put your love out on these people and your grace and your mercy? And it really is because of nights like this. It's because, you know, we get to choose. We get to make a choice. Angels choose to worship God. I believe it. I think they do. Why else would some have fallen? Why did some choose to fall, you know? And we get this choice here on earth, not in heaven. It'd be one thing to choose, you know, when you're in heaven to worship God. But when you're on this earth and you have trials and struggles and tribulations and all these things that God said would come and do come, but then he comes and it's nothing. And that's, I just love that song because I picture that song of them singing in heaven and then walking away from church service to go back to their houses, and they're like, what is it that would turn God's eyes away from all of creation, of heaven down to earth, to these people?
That's right.
What is it? Yes. You know, I don't know what it is, but it's something. And I love that verse because it startled me one day. It's like, what in the world would angels long to look into? You know, they have holy every day.
That's right.
You know, so
yes.
Remember, when you choose, when we choose to worship God in the morning, Monday mornings have just been bad. But tomorrow morning, I'm going to get up different, and I'm going to go out into the living room instead of sitting on the couch listening to the devil speak all these lies. I'm just going to choose. It's Monday morning. Thank you, Jesus. Another Monday morning, right? Thank you.
So good. We're going to have Courtney close us out. And then we're going to do my favorite part. And I felt like saving it for last today. Some of you know what that is. There's something I love you more than worship.
Testimonies.
So we're going to worship just a little longer. And I just encourage you to really think about what you just said. That was so good. Your presence is all I I did hear the Lord say something. I got to pray something. We are Facebook Live. But I, and he wants me to say something before I sign off on there. He said he is clearing people's lungs from this smoke in the air. So Father, I thank you that lungs are being opened, not just here, but online. God, I thank you that people right now are starting to breathe better. Right now, thank you, Jesus, for opening up the airways. No more coughing, no more wheezing. There's no reason for it. So Father, I thank you for opening the airways, God. Open up the airways. Opening up the airways. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you for your presence. Lord, I thank you that you have turned the page. From this moment on, everything is different. We make choices, like you were saying too. We can choose to keep walking in our disappointment or our whatever it is, or we can choose to trust God. I pray that all of us here will choose whatever's been opposing us, that we will choose the opposite from this night forward. Lord, I thank you for clear minds. I thank you for a restful night's sleep for everyone. Sweet sleep. That's what the word says. Sweet sleep.
Amen.
So Father, I thank you.
Lord.
For just being a good Father.